Hey guys, Xenom here, and this is going to be another part of the introduction to StarCraft lore. I should actually probably turn these sounds down. I want those on. Whatever. Okay, so in the first part of the StarCraft, the original StarCraft campaign, you play a Terran magistrate on the planet, or that comes from the planet Marsara. So right now you've been tasked, or your planet is tasked with evacuation, and you're to find this local marshal, Jim Raynor.
Howdy, boys. I'm Jim Raynor, marshal of these parts.
There we go. The rest of the mission is actually pretty boring, so I'm just going to talk about Jim Raynor while I complete this.
Sounds fun, Commander.
Can I read you?
Okay, so Jim Raynor is, if you played the campaign before, you know that he's a pretty important person, and we'll actually see that later. I was originally going to play through every single mission in this campaign and in Brood Wars campaign, but I tried doing that. I was playing through yesterday and kind of casting it alongside, but it's just so much time to fill with so little information. So I'm just going to kind of, whenever I see a new character, whenever there's another mission that where something important happens, I'm just going to talk about that for a little bit and then just kind of finish the rest of the mission really quickly. So this is Jim Raynor. He's very important. Right now he's just a kind of backwater marshal. This isn't a very thriving planet. It's okay. But one of the other planets that was one of the other planets in this star system, so kind of like a solar system, so was just obliterated by the Protoss under Tassadar, who I'll talk about later when I get to the Protoss campaign. So that there was a planet obliterated by Tassadar's fleet, and that was because it was infested with Zerg. So right now, you as the Magistrate and Jim Raynor are going to try and evacuate as many people as you can to try and... just save as many people as you can.
Raynor here.
Raynor was part of the Raynor's Rangers, which isn't really too important on itself, but it does... during that time, he did meet Tychus Finley, who was going to play some role in StarCraft II. I didn't want to spoil it for myself, so I didn't look any further than that. And, Raynor here. Yeah, I think the rest of... I'll talk about Raynor more as the campaign moves on, but that's pretty much all I need to say at this point. He's a vulture right now, but eventually he does, whenever he needs to go on foot, he becomes a marine. I'll just wait for this barracks to get finished, so I'll actually just cheat a little bit here.
Infantry units such as marines can be trained at this facility.
And finish up the mission right there.
You want a piece of me, boy?
That should be it. Alright, seeing I'm here again, this is going to be a continuation of the... Well, I hope I edited this right, and it's just picking up straight where the last one left off after I finished that mission. So now, a few things have happened. So, we did evacuate the world of Marsara, but to do that, we had to kind of flee.
This is Jimmy.
And, because Jim Raynor and his band of friends, or... militia, did have to take down a Confederate command center, which was infested. So the Confederates are kind of like the bad guys. That's pretty much all there is to say. There was an introduction of General Edmund Duke, who is the Confederate general, probably the highest, the only ranked Confederate soldier that you ever meet, to my knowledge. Sorry about that, my throat's kind of raspy lately. So you had to take down a command center that was infested. I might try and put a picture of that later on. And now you're... Okay, and then you had to ally yourselves with a kind of terrorist group under Arcturus Manx called the Sons of Korhal. Manx is the son of a... former revolutionary leader. Well, his dad is dead. And So Max helped you out there, but he made you go into, he made you and Rainer go into a, what's it called, kind of like a lab to retrieve some data disks, because they, Max thought that the UED was researching new weapons, so he wanted to get a piece of that. And they're kind of, right now, they're finishing the data extraction from those disks. And we're tasked with meeting up with Kerrigan, a ghost. Here she is.
Captain Rainer, I finished scouting out the area and... You pig!
What? I haven't even said anything to you yet.
Yeah, but you were thinking it.
Oh, yeah. You're a telepath. Look, let's just get on with this, okay?
Right.
Later on, Kerrigan and Rainer do form a very strong bond. Kerrigan is actually working for Manx as his second in command right now. And, yeah, I guess I can talk about that now. So, the reason why she's working for Manx is because she was actually... Wait up. Yeah, I guess I can talk about her abilities. So, Kerrigan is a ghost. I wanted to do a separate thing on ghosts later on. So I'll just talk about Kerrigan for now.
I'm ready.
So Kerrigan is working for Max because the Confederates had a ghost program, and yeah, had a ghost program, or still has a ghost program actually. And Kerrigan is one of their most successful trainees. So Kerrigan is let's see. She's working for Max because at the ghost program. She was undergoing some more treatment. She had already kind of finished the training, but she was still being used for experiments.
Lieutenant Kerrigan reporting.
On the Confederates were using Kerrigan to experiment with the Zerg, and they found out that her powers could actually be used to control some of the isolated Zerg larvae and eggs. That control creep, it's kind of weird. They don't actually do that in the game, but... Oh, by the way, ghosts can cloak and lock down and nuke later on. Kerrigan is actually a very nice ghost with 3 additional armor, 205 extra life, and triple the damage. That's pretty much it. Oh, right now we're trying to liberate the Antigans, these purple guys, from the control of the Confederates, who are these white guys. So the Confederates, the Antigans haven't rebelled yet, but it's kind of in the works. At least it was until the Confederates kind of left a blockade over here. Maybe not a blockade, I'm not sure what the correct wording is for that. I'm just gonna walk in here. She should take some damage, but she should be okay.
I read you. I gotcha.
There we go.
Thinking the same thing. It'd be a pleasure.
And now,
Thinking the same thing. I've taken care of business on this end, Commander. I think the Antigans are ready to back us up, too.
That's right. We've tolerated these Confederate goons long enough.
So there we go, the Antigans do successfully rebel, and that's actually pretty much it for this mission. There's a base I need to kill after this, but it's not really too big of a thing. So that's the main thing, and Kerrigan and Rainer do free the Antigans from Confederate control. Yeah, that's probably a good word for it.